Welcome to our class. This is the astronomy class. If you're not supposed to be in astronomy, well, you can watch the video if you want to and just be generally entertained and learn a lot about the planets and the moons and the asteroids and the green clovers and blue diamonds. No, that's Lucky Charms. Sorry. I am going to be your host. I am Kurt Messick. I'm your professor. Just in case you had trouble learning that name, here's a little bit of help for you.
Messick.
Mr. Messick.
Your teacher. Kurt Messick.
Mr. Messick.
Kurt Messicks.
Kurt.
It sounds weird when I say it like that. Kurt Messicks.
Kurt.
I hope that's how I'm pronouncing your last name right.
Kurt Messick.
I've beamed in at Professor Messick's request.
Mr. Messick wanted me to stop by.
And a wonderful teacher like Kurt Messick.
Kurt Messick.
Your professor, Kurt Messick.
Kurt Messick.
Mr. Kurt Messick.
Kurt Messick, a teacher.
Mr. Messick.
Your professor, Kurt Messick.
Professor Kurt Messick? That is singular.
Your wonderful teacher, Kurt Messick, or Mr. Messick?
Hello, Kurt.
Hey, students, listen, Kurt's a great guy.
You're a lovely teacher, Mr. Messick. I call him Kurt, because that's his name.
Yeah, I don't know. Does he let you call you Kurt, or do you call him Mr. K? You call him Mr. Messick, Mr. M? I don't know. I know some teachers don't want to get personal with their students, so they just call me Mr. Messick.
Professor Kurt Messick.
Keep studying with Kurt.
I really have nothing else to say, Kurt.
Professor Kurt Messick is going to save us all, and he's starting with you guys.
Okay. One of the things you might notice throughout this class is that we're going to have some people virtually stopping by. You just got a brief preview of some of the ones who will be coming in to see you. They've pre-recorded messages, although occasionally I might get someone new who might actually even stop by during a regular Zoom meeting. You just never know. So stay tuned for that. You are a student at
Ivy Tech Community College.
At Ivy Tech Community College.
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 I took Earth Science at Ivy Tech.
Ivy Tech Community College.
Ivy Tech.
Ivy Tech Community College.
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 Expanding your knowledge at Ivy Tech Community College.
So by now you should know the college that you're in. Hopefully you already knew that before. And you should know my name. Hopefully you already knew that before too. But I also hope that you know now that you're going to have a good time in this class. I'm going to be putting up something in the syllabus. You should read the syllabus because there's some big names telling you, you got to read the syllabus.
A message from Big Snoop D-O-double-G to all these students. Yo, syllabus. You got to do it. You got to read it. Man, I'm telling you, the more you know, the further you go. Tell them Snoop Dogg sent you. Syllabus. I know all about it. Catch up so we can have a conversation. Don't be late. Let's go.
And I will, in fact, hold you responsible for the syllabus. There are any number of times you will ask me questions, and one of the things I'm going to do is I'm going to get Snoop Dogg to come back and say, it's in the syllabus. So don't be surprised at that. I will put up things in a lot of different places in our Canvas area, but mostly I want you to pay attention to the announcements and pay attention to the modules. Those are the two main areas. Oh, hey, the background is disappearing. They're trying to beam me up. Oh, no. But the northern lights that are here up in Iceland, get used to Iceland. I go there a lot. I talk about it a lot. You'll get sick of it before the end. But I may even have a couple of videos from Iceland that I will intersperse. In fact, I might do one right now.
Thank you.
Just like that. There you go. Stay tuned. Be with us. I will post up a couple of different videos about how I conduct Zoom, how I conduct lectures, how I conduct a lot of different things. The classes I've got, just so you know, I am doing this video, if you're watching it now, in January of 2021. Welcome to the new year. I'm doing this for three classes. Oh, again, my hands are disappearing. Three classes that I have in progress now. I have an Astronomy 101 class, and that Astronomy 101 class meets on Monday and Wednesday from 11 o'clock onward, 11 in the morning, not the night. That's actually important to say when you're dealing with astronomy. I have an Astronomy 102 class, which meets at 9 o'clock, again in the morning, on Tuesday and Thursday. And then I also have a Science 100 class, which is Earth Science, which meets on Wednesday and Thursday evenings at 6 o'clock. Now, here's the thing, the reason why I'm telling all of you all of this. I will be on Zoom at all of those times. So you can look for me on Zoom at 11 o'clock on Monday and Wednesday, at 9 o'clock on Tuesday and Thursday, and at 6 p.m., 6 in the evening, on Wednesday and Thursday. Any of you can come to any of those sessions because I treat them as though they were office hour or question and answer sessions. So I typically do not have too many people coming to those sessions. So you can get information from me. You can ask questions. You do not have to show up and sit there for 2 hours or 4 hours or however many hours, because I have pre-recorded the lectures. I think that I've already mentioned that before, and you can watch them on your own. What I would suggest you do is watch the lectures, and then if you have any questions out of those lectures, come to the Zoom times that are set up for our class. I will have other office hours also posted, and those you can find in the syllabus. Remember, Snoop Dogg will talk about the syllabus here. And those I will not have as just sort of sitting on a Zoom channel. You need to make arrangements for me to join you in Zoom for the official office hours. But for the particular class hours, and I'll post this up in the announcements in your classroom, for any of the three classes I'm teaching, you can come to those Zoom sessions. The Astronomy 102 class is a 16-week class, and the Earth Science class, Science 100 class, is a 16-week class. So both of those I'll be with you until May. The Astronomy 101 class is an 8-week class, so that one will get done by March, by spring break. Now, they are all set up in systems of 8. So whenever I'm talking about a module in our 101 class, we have 8 modules. Each one takes 1 week. For the 102 class and the Science 100 class, they also have 8 modules, but they each give you 2 weeks to do them. So that's going to be the difference. So if you ever hear me saying anything that sounds like, oh, well, I'm not in a 16-week class, that's meaning for the other class, or I'm not in an 8-week class, that's meant for the other class. Because I will have the lectures pre-recorded. I've already done the lectures up for you, so I'll have those up there for you. I'll probably be modifying them here or there for this semester because things change. The sky changes, information changes, but some of it stays the same, and I'll let you know if there's ever anything like, hey, that video is out of date, you need to pay attention to this one. But we will, in general, have 2 lectures per week. Those will be on video, so you can watch them whenever. There will be deadlines. I'm somewhat flexible on deadlines. I am not completely flexible on deadlines. My late policy, and I will refer you back to this video whenever you ask me about late policies. Here's the thing. To minimize the number of emails and messages and other kinds of things that are happening here, this is the late policy. I don't care if you're a couple of days late. I really don't. It doesn't matter to me at all, because I will often not grade your things until like 3 or 4 or 5 days after they're due. So as long as things are in by the time I'm grading it, I don't care. By the time I've posted a 0 in your column for the assignment, then it becomes dicey, then it becomes tricky. Because one of the things that happens with our labs, one of the things that happens with discussion boards, is that they are expected to be in a timely manner. And especially for many of the labs that we'll be doing, you need to do one before you do the other and need to do the other. And the scientific process is an expectation that you're not going to do it sort of all in one big blat. In fact, this is important. And I had someone do this just last semester, and that person got a really bad grade in the class. Do not. Wait until the last module or the last week or the last 2 weeks of class and then try to throw everything up there. Do not do that, because I will not go back to week one when we're in week 15, or even for the 8 week class when we're in week 7 and grade that stuff. I'm not going to do it. You need to be doing things more or less on target with what everything is. There are a couple of different reasons for that, and I'm not going to belabor the point too much. One is, I don't have an infinite amount of time in week 15. I do not have enough hours. See, week 15 has 168 hours. Week one has 168 hours. That's 7 times 24. I can't take the hour that I didn't use in week one to grade your stuff and put it in week 15 and therefore have 169 hours or 170 hours or 172 hours or however many hours. I don't have extra hours in that time to grade all the stuff, because it's not going to be just one student. I literally have 100 students over the course of a semester. And if you ever wondered why professors don't want to take late work, that's the primary reason why. It's because I can't bank the time over here and move it over here. Time can't be saved that way. The other point is, especially for the labs, you need to do them in sequence, and you need to be doing them in a way where you can process the information before you get to the next one. And if you're not doing it over time, you're not actually getting what you're supposed to be getting out of the lab. Just like a gym class, or just like practicing music, or just like learning a language, or any kind of thing like that. If you just sort of wait until the last minute, if you're supposed to be doing, say, running a mile every day, you can't just wait until day 30 and run 30 miles. Most of us, our bodies don't work that way. Well, time doesn't work that way either. So beware of that. I will not grade things in that fashion. And discussion boards in particular, they need to be done when they need to be done. That's how I'm gauging your attendance in the class, is by the discussion board. So by the time a zero goes up in the discussion board, that's it. There won't be any points awarded for that. They need to be done in a timely fashion. The labs also need to be done in a timely fashion. The quizzes I'm not so worried about, because the quizzes you can sort of do on your own, but it's better to stay up to snuff with those. Those will be auto graders. So you can, again, as long as there's not a zero in something already, you can go ahead and do it. Once there's a zero in it, chances are good there won't be any points available for that. Now, here's the other thing. Here's the good part of all of that. I am the king of extra credit. Where's my crown? Somewhere I have a crown. Well, I don't have a crown here with me. It's in my office and I'm working from home. I do have my tinfoil hat. So I'll put on my tinfoil hat. Oh, it's warm. Okay. Yes, I am the king of extra credit. So if you miss points somewhere along the way, chances are good there will be something that you can do to make up those points later. So in our class, think about it as time's arrow. Always look forward, never look back. Always go forward in our class. So there is sort of accountability, but there's also grace and redemption. I am Father Kurt. I have studied theology and other kinds of things like that. So yes, it's not the end of the world if you don't get things done occasionally. But again, there will not be infinite amounts of extra credit. There will not be infinite amounts of things that you can do. And you will not. In fact, there will probably be a point around 3/4 of the class, if you haven't been doing things, where I'm going to come to you and tell you it's time to drop the class, because there won't be enough points available for you to pass. So don't let that happen. Don't let that happen. There's so many ways to pass the course. You actually have to work hard to not pass the course. So don't let that happen. Let's see, what else do I need to tell you? I think that's pretty much it. So I'm going to splice this in to the other video and we'll have a good time. So do not. And I will repost this video at the end of the semester. If you do this, do not come to me in having not done anything since week one and say, what can I do to pass? Because what I will tell you then is what I'm telling you now. Sign up for next semester. So if you're a few days here and there late, I don't care. I really don't care. If you're a week late, it begins to get a bit iffy with that. If you're 3 or 4 weeks late, we need to talk and I'll get Snoop Dogg on you again. I look forward to seeing you. I will give you more information on how the labs work during our first week. I will be posting up the modules on Monday for the Monday-Wednesday class and on Tuesday for the Tuesday-Thursday class. And the way things will operate, I'll post things up on Monday for the Monday-Wednesday class, and everything will be due the next Monday. So they won't be due on Sunday, they'll be due the next Monday. For the Tuesday-Thursday class, I'll be posting up everything on Tuesday, and all of your things will be due the following Tuesday. So that's the way that will work. And I will have those Monday, Wednesday, Tuesday, Thursday Zooms every week. I will also do Sunday evening Zooms. Those will usually be around 7 o'clock at night. So I'll be there from 7 to 8, but sometimes it may adjust up or down because I do have a couple of other things I do on a monthly basis on Sundays. So watch out for that. And I'm happy to Zoom with you at any time other than the official Zoom times so that we can sort of see if you have a better time for you. I'm at home a lot. I work from home right now. I'm in my office occasionally, but mostly I'm home. So stay tuned for more, and I welcome you to the class. Okay, and one of the things that I will also be doing is you may notice that there are edits and cuts and clips and other kinds of things along the way in our videos. And sometimes it will look like the things don't quite match up. And that's because I am, in fact, updating videos that I have done before with new information. I try whenever possible to wear the same shirt, but sometimes my hair may be different, or the quality of the audio may be different because I have a new microphone or whatever. So I'm doing the best I can to make things seamless, but every now and then you're going to have some abrupt clips here and there. And this is obviously one of them.